certainly as a person who's been out there serving in dangerous contexts, but also helping people become leaders, you've been in places where you've swung for the fences and missed. Could you share a time or a place when that happened to you?
Seven of my soldiers were involved in a training accident in which five of them were killed. And it was at 2 o'clock in the morning. They drove an armored vehicle off a bridge into deep water just south of the demilitarized zone in the Republic of Korea. And as I faced that crisis, that challenge, as a leader, I assume responsibility for their training, for their lives. And at some level, I believe I failed them. I believe that if I had operated more acutely in terms of driver's training and in terms of the complex operation that I had ongoing, that perhaps they would have been better trained and they wouldn't have fallen victim to that accident. It caused me to realize, too, because of the way I was treated by my leaders, how a leader needs to be treated in a crisis. It taught me humility. It taught me that it's important to coach people through that. And I was coached by a wonderful two-star general named Bob Dees, who met me on that bridge as they were still recovering bodies. The first thing he said to me was, "You know, Tom, it's not what happens to an organization that determines its success or failure. It's how the leader responds to that that really matters." And I'll never forget that. And it's made me very resilient in other crises, and I hope it's made me a better leader to other people who were in crises who needed support from the top.